In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can add a dark mode on our WordPress website. So we are going to turn our website layout, which looks like this, in the normal or the light mode. And we are going to turn this into a dark mode, which will look something like this. So we will be using the dark mode block from the plus add-ons for Gutenberg, and with this we will be able to add this dark mode. So if that sounds interesting and you also want to add dark mode in your WordPress website, then hop in and I'll show you everything step by step. My name is Ankit Sharma from the team POSIMYTH, and if you want to deep dive in the world of WordPress using Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. We are going to create this dark mode in just 4 simple steps. In step number 1, we are going to add or configure the global color palette for our light mode. And in step number 2, we are going to configure the color palette or the global color preset for our dark mode. And then in step number 3, we are going to assign our colors to the various elements on our page. And in the fourth and the final step, we are going to add the dark mode block on our page and do the basic configuration to make it work. So let's dive in our WordPress backend and see how we can do this. So here we are in our WordPress backend, and if we go in the plugin section, here we have the plus add-ons for block editor free as well as the pro version. But in order to add this dark mode, you don't need the pro version of this plugin. You can do that by just adding the plus add-ons for block editor free version. And once you have installed this, you can now go to plus settings and then click on plus blocks. And here we will search for dark. So this is the dark mode block. And as you can see, it's part of the free plugin. And in order to make it work, make sure you turn this on. And then click on save. And now we can go to our step number 1, that is creating the color palette for our light mode or our normal mode. So let's go to pages and create a new one. And let's call it dark mode. And here we need to go to this top right corner on this icon where it says plus customizer. Let's click on this. And here we have global presets. And we right now have 2 presets, number 1 and number 2. And we are going to use both of them to configure the color settings or the color code for our normal as well as our dark mode. So first, let's go ahead and rename this preset 1. We go to this wrench icon. Here we have this rename option. And we'll call it light mode. And after this, let's click on it. And the first option we see here is global colors. If we click here, now here we see some colors that are predefined, and for the name it says primary, secondary and so on. But we can rename that as well to make it look something user friendly. So we have already decided what color code we are going to choose. So this is our color code. So we are going to choose this color code for our light mode and this one for our dark mode. So let me just quickly go ahead and rename all of these color palettes first, and then we will add these color code. So in order to rename this, all you have to do is just click on this wrench icon and then click on rename and just give it any name as you want. And you can do the same for all of these color codes, and even you can add a new one as well. If you want to delete any of the color code, all you have to do is just click on this wrench icon again and then click on delete. So now we have just renamed all of these color palettes so that it will look a little bit user friendly. And now it's time to update these color codes. So let's go ahead and open our color palette here, and let's copy the first code for our heading. And if we click here, and in order to edit this color code, we need to click on this icon here and then just paste our color code. Then let's go for the text. And in the same way, we can update all these color codes. Alright, so all of our color code in the light mode are ready. So we can close this. And now let's rename this preset to, and let's call it dark mode. And once again, we will go ahead and change the name of these color palettes and then change the color code. So let me just quickly go ahead and do that. So now we are ready with the dark mode color palette as well. And in order to save both of them, we need to just scroll down a bit and then click on save preset. Now here we can see that our light mode is selected as default. We see this green check mark here. Now just in case you want to make this one as default, all you have to do is just click on this wrench icon here and then click on activate. So this one will become activated and will act as your default color preset. But we need to use this as the color preset for our dark mode. So for that, we need to choose this second last option, that is dark mode. So let's click here. Now this moon icon denotes that this color preset or this global preset will be acting as our dark mode. Now let's go ahead and create a sample page and then move on to our step number 3, and there we will assign our global colors to various elements on our page. So this is a page that we have designed, and as you can see, we have various elements on this page. So let's go and start from the very top and we select this main row here. And then we go to style, and here for the background color, we will choose the global color and we will choose this dark background color. And then we will select this heading and we go back to style, and here we will select the color as in our link or as in our icon color. And for our headings, again we go back to style and using our global color palette, we have selected the color for our headings. And in the same way, we can assign colors to all these elements on our page using our global color palette. Now while adding these colors to various elements on our page, we will only see one color palette here, and that is the one which is activated, which will have this green check mark here. So we don't have to worry about the color codes of dark mode. They will automatically get switched to the respective colors that we have added here. So the first color from the normal or the default mode will be switched with the first color in the dark mode. And that's how it's going to follow for rest of the color codes. And now we can go to the very bottom of the page. And here we will search for dark mode. So this is the TP dark mode block. Let's click on this, and by default this is how it's going to look, and we can change this style from the layout section here, and we have various predefined styles here. So if we choose this one, so this is the style 1 and this one is the style 2 and then the style 3. I like the minimal look of this style 3, so we are going to use this one. And with that, you can also change the icon here. So I'm going to leave it as it is. And now for the dark icon, this is the icon we are going to use for the dark mode. And once again, we can change that as well. After this, we have an option to save in cookies. So this will actually remember the choice whenever the visitor visits the web page again. So if they have selected dark mode, so whenever they visit the website again, it's going to save it in the cookies and it will always show the dark mode. After that, we have a very important option, that is auto match OS theme, which means that if in case the user has set the browser to the dark mode, then this will detect that dark mode from the browser and it will automatically open the website in the dark mode. So the visitor don't have to switch the website in dark mode manually. And then comes the position. So here we have the relative, absolute and fixed position. So we are going to use the fixed one. And as you can see, it's going to be fixed on the top left corner. So here we can change the offset value. So we are going to leave it as it is. Along with that, if we go on the style tab, here we can edit the size of the icon like this. Or maybe you can change the background size, something like this. So you can play around with all of these settings. And here you can define the style for the light mode, this one. So maybe you want to change the icon color to something like yellow. And for the dark mode, we can change the icon color maybe to white. And same we can do for the background as well. So let's go ahead and update this and see how it looks in the front end. So this is the sample page that we have designed. And right now it is in the light mode and it's using the default global preset colors. Now if we go ahead and switch it to dark mode, it's going to choose the colors that we have assigned in the dark mode global preset. And as you can see, it successfully updated the color for text as well as the background and for the buttons as well as for the icons. So this is how easy it is to create a dark mode on your WordPress website using the plus add-ons for Gutenberg. If you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button and share it with your friends and community who wish to add this kind of dark mode on their website. And if you want to learn more about what else you can do with the plus add-ons for Gutenberg, then make sure you subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. So that's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.